The focus over here, again, is designed to bring your attention. It's designed to bring your attention to how this tariff shifting analysis works. When you see a product, so usually whenever you have something, right, you focus on whatever change is taking place in a NAFTA country from NAFTA country. Here you have Turkey going to the United States. So here the question is, what's taking place in the United States once it goes to Mexico, right? And of course, it goes from Mexico, it goes back. So the focus is what's taking place in the United States, not what's what's taking place in Mexico, because the focus is the immediate country, right? So whatever. So first step is to see to identify non-NAFTA country, and the second step to identify NAFTA country, and to see what is taking place, what kind of manufacturing process is taking place in NAFTA country. That's the point of this chart. Now, I use the tobacco example. And the reason I use tobacco example is because customs examiners have asked about tobacco before. And notice you have tobacco product under this HTS-US number. So you have HTS-US number 2024-01-30-03. And it came in and it was changed in the United States into the 2403-9120. All right. So the key here is, did that change qualify for NAFTA? And of course, this question deals with a tariff shifting. So what's the rule here? The rule here is, let's see, and all right, so so the rule is to see whether or not it qualifies for it conforms to NAFTA processing, NAFTA tariff shift classification. We see that you have chapter 24. So what we do is we go to the chapter 24, and we see what rule qualifies for the chapter 24. And we find the chapter 24 rules in the general note 12. All right, here's what it says. A change to heading 2401 through 2403 from tariff items and at least the items or any other chapter. We know that there is no change from any other chapter has occurred, so any other chapter clause is not applicable. So we have to look at whether this change, we have to look at the details and whether this is provided on the list. We have 2401, we have changed from 3003 to 9120. 2401-30 is not listed. And because it's not one of those on the list, NAFTA it does not meet the change, it does not meet the rule, the chapter 24 rule in the general note 12T. Therefore, the product does not qualify for NAFTA. And so that was the point of this exercise. So whatever happened to the product, tobacco product, as I described here, is not applicable because it is not part. It does not fit the rule by HTS-US. So by looking at this at the previous customs broker exam question, you pretty much have the following situation. You have European grown and processed tobacco comes into the subheading. So this is, I use Turkey as an example. Customs examiners use Europe, fine. The focus is on Mexico, enters the United States, and then goes to Mexico. So what's being done in Mexico? So it comes in under 2403, 3003. It enters the United States. In the United States, it changes into the 9120. So same, pretty much the same pattern, right? The goods are further processed in Mexico, and they finally return into the under the subheading 9920. So see, in Mexico, nothing changed, right? So the question is, do other goods imported into the United States from Mexico qualify to receive NAFTA? And we know it doesn't fit NAFTA because it didn't fit that fact pattern, or that general No. 12 rule, right? It did not qualify for this. So therefore, no NAFTA. And because no NAFTA, the answer is no, goods definitely not qualify. Yeah, so B, that makes B the correct answer choice. So this is another example of tariff shifting question that have been asked by customs examiners in the past. So let's look at the other real quick. This can only be determined by the US-Mexico NAFTA technical committee. No, there is NAFTA organizational bodies which serve like for arbitration purposes, for dispute resolution purposes. This is not a correct answer choice because it's just way outside. You have rules. Rules are set in the paper. Follow the rules. So this discretionary stuff is not part of the equation. See, yes, the goods qualify without condition. No, there are always conditions. NAFTA is all about strings attached. So that's not a correct choice. D, only if the goods are satisfactorily labeled as would require health warnings. Health warnings are usually the jurisdiction of other agencies. Here it would be the alcohol ATF, alcohol, tobacco, and firearms. So whatever they require is not responsive to the call of a question, because do the goods imported into the United States or Mexico qualify to receive NAFTA? This is not responsive to NAFTA, it's responsive to the PGA requirement. So D is not the best answer choice here either. Provisionally, pending verification of compliance with USDA product quality standards is same as with D. It's not responsive to the call of the question. So E is incorrect, making B a correct answer choice.